eminent speakers on the dais, dignitaries, and the doctors.
He has come all the way from Bangalore, leaving his busy practice. Though I told him only 15 minutes, still he came all the way and going back tomorrow. Thank you, doctor.
Thank you. Any doctors in the audience? Medical doctors? Thank you. Good evening to all of you. My name is Dr. Srinivasamurthy D. I am a graduate from Bangalore Medical College from the 1978 batch. Afterwards, I have done my post-graduation in nutrition and preventive care. I worked in abroad for about 17 long years. And I am proud to say that I was the doctor for Rajiv Gandhi and his family in the year 1986. And I worked a lot at the UNDP levels in many countries, starting from Andaman, your own Andamans, to African countries and even in Caribbean islands also. In the last 8 years, I am practicing therapeutic lasers or regenerative medicine using the quantum energy medicine. My perception, understanding and knowledge of quantum energy medicine has a timelining of 117 years dating back to Albert Einstein and Max Planck, and later the modern day medicine, Dr. Michael Hamblin, the professor and head of the Department of Photomedicine in Harvard Medical University. And then Madam Janita Endres, she is a professor of neurosurgery and a representative, White House representative for quantum energy medicine to the world. And then Idi Abraham is the professor and head of the Department of Quantum Energy Department in Johannesburg University. Professor Shimon Roshkind, the neurosurgeon from the Israel University. And many of the research scholars from the Indian Institute of Science and other institutions in the country. And my knowledge also goes to the by attending innumerable conferences all over the world and my practice in the last 8 years. So I'll just take 5 minutes extra grace from our great Karthikeyan sir, because I have made some presentations and that I have to present it. So I want to tell you that I am talking about the role of quantum energy medicine, regenerative medicine, under the heading or under the platform, the quantum healing. The word quantum has got great meaning and it takes hours together for explanation, but within few seconds I want to say that quantum is the lowest unit of energy or matter. That is the photon that is emitted from the electrons of an atom. So I don't want to go too much into the quantum physics and quantum mechanics. So that is what, when once these photons can be emitted spontaneously or by stimulation. Whatever that we use in our practice, they are all stimulated emission of radiation that is called as a laser. Light emitted, you understand that, LASER, light amplified stimulated emission of radiation. And there are many things in that field, the many new developments are happening even in the last 8 years, even in this year also. That is about the quantum energy. And the healing part, we medical doctors, the modern medical doctors, we do not fall into the category of the healing, because healing is something supreme, natural. We consider that we just care the things, we just care the situation, and the healing part is taken by him. He alone, it is only by nature. So that is what our purview as far as the healing is concerned. Now let us come to the regenerative medicine, what exactly the regenerative medicine is and what is the background of the quantum energy medicine. I'll just go ahead now. Okay, before that, let us enjoy this photograph of 1927 quantum energy conference in Europe. In that, you can see that Albert Einstein is there and Madame Curie also is there. There are 29 eminent scientists are there. Out of that, 17 of them got a Nobel Prize. This is the rarest photo that I retained for my quantum energy purposes. Now, let us study, before going anything, the regenerative medicine or quantum energy. We know that we have studied already the atomic structure and everything. Let us see the cell. What the cell, the normal cell function, like us, they also breathe, they also eat and digest, and they also produce other required things, and they also reproduct functioning. That is, they also reproduce. That's all. What is the normal functioning? When we say the cell is normal, it has to breathe properly at the mitochondrial level, and it has to take food across the cell wall, and it has to digest the food with the vesicles and other things. And Golgi apparatus, they have to produce so many enzymes, so many proteins, so many hormones required for the body. And then at the nucleus level, they have to duplicate and they have to produce new cells. So this is the ultimate type of any cell and the nature. What is degeneration we call? When cell is damaged due to so many reasons, maybe some deficiencies, maybe some toxins, or maybe so many other things, we call it as the functional degradation. Regenerative medicine, that which repairs, regenerates, and replaces the damaged or diseased cells is called regenerative medicine. It is very simple. Okay? Now we call that regenerative medicine is a process of repairing, replacing, regenerating human cells to restore or establish normal function by stimulating the body's own repair mechanism. This is very, very important. Of everything, the regenerative medicine, it is stimulating the body's own repair mechanism is more important here. And then there are so many advanced biomedical approaches we follow in regenerative medicine, that is stem cell therapy and then immunomodulation therapy and tissue engineering. But of all the, these are all at a very higher level, higher end of regenerative medicine. But the lower end, where 90% of the actions can be taken, is at the preventive care, metabolic disorders, and targeted nutrition and quantum energy medicine. This is what is I am following from the last 8 years. Okay? And now, before going to the quantum energy or the lasers, what we call therapeutic lasers, let us see the what is the role of light in medical practice. We know that the natural sunlight is very, very essential for the vitamin D synthesis in the body. No arguments in this. And we use ultraviolet ray to use to help to treat the skin conditions of psoriatic patients, we know very well. And phototherapy in case of neonatal jaundice, we use, there's no, and lack of sunlight, particularly in the Scandinavian countries, it causes a condition called a seasonal affect disorder with the depression. So we know very well that the light has got a definite effect on the human health. And these therapeutic lasers are lasers, are just improved version of light produced by using a segment of light spectrum. The light spectrum is 650 nanometers to 1000 nanometers wavelength. That is, the red and the infrared part of the electromagnetic spectrum of the light is being used to stimulate the cell, stimulate the lasing materials, and we produce lasers. And now we can ask the question, because light is being used in the medical practice so well, why the therapeutic lasers are required? Why and what for? It is a million-dollar question. It was in the 8 years back, but not now. Most of the doctors are accepting it now. If you look at the present, the global status of the quantum energy medicine or therapeutic lasers, FDA has classified therapeutic lasers as class 3B instruments. USA Olympic Academy, Navy, Army, Air Force, Submarine Fleet, and many major health institutions, including the NIH, National Institute of Health, where I worked extensively with particularly the Iraq war injured soldiers, they are using therapeutic lasers. NASA Space Shuttle Mission, Space Station astronauts, and there are more than 30,000 practitioners in USA, Canada, Europe, UK, and Japan mainly. 2,500 research papers, more than half of them are double-blind studies are there. World Association for Laser Therapy, North American Association for Laser Therapy, Australian Association for Medical Laser Association, Russian Laser Association, even Indian Association for Laser Therapy, it is already formed. I am the present president of that. It is called also the photobiology, radiobiology, photomedicine, quantum medicine, and occupied a position in integral part in regenerative medicine. So that is the powerful positioning of quantum energy medicine all over the world. Now, I just want to show you some of the different laser machines or the quantum energy medicine. What is quantum energy medicine? We have to understand very well. The quantum energy is produced. This quantum energy is also called lasers, that is being used in industries, that is being used in robotics, it is being used in for surgery also. But the quantum energy medicine is that between 650 nanometers to 1000 nanometers that does not cut and burn the tissues. Instead of that, it stimulates the cellular functions. That is why it is called as medicine. We have to understand that. So these are some of the equipments that are available. About 8 years back, they were all costing around 17 lakhs, 19 lakhs, and all. Now they have come down less than 5 lakh rupees. That is the most advanced thing, that because of the buying, number of units are buying, they also brought it down. The present one, the last, the fourth one is that I am using it. In fact, I have brought it for the demonstration purpose here. It's okay. In the last, when people are interested for them, we can do it. Yes. See, this is the picture that I have taken it from the library of the National Institute of Health, Bethesda, USA, where all the quantum energy or quantum energy medicine or the therapeutic lasers are being used. From head to toe, there are so many conditions that they are using it. And even, you know, for the last 4 years, I am seeing it for the laser blood irradiation and the cardiac issues also. I do not want to confuse you with the minimum time that I am having. I try to confine myself to the chronic degenerative conditions. My dear friend, okay. Yeah. See, this quantum energy medicine of the therapeutic lasers.
Can you go back to the previous slide?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, tinnitus, that is the ringing in the ears.
There is some gentleman here, a very senior officer, having a serious problem. Can you explain about that? How does it happen?
See, the tinnitus is something these patients hear, which normally the outside sounds are not there. It is the production inside that is due to the cochlear lymphedema. We have treated enough cases of that. And through transmeatal laser applications we have treated, wherein it brings down the edema in the cochlea and the patients enjoy it. In my hospital, one 26-year-old lady who was a IAS studying, and she, it was disturbing to her, and we cleared her issue, and she has completed even her IAS also last year. It is. I am telling you. What I am telling you here is that straight away I'll just say that I got nearly 41 years of medical practice experience all over the world after my MBBS. What I did not learn in my MBBS, what I did not enjoy or what I did not understand and implement in my 33 years of my practice, I learnt in the last 8 years. Every day is an enjoyable thing for me. New things are happening. In the last 3 months, you know, we have treated enough number of Parkinson's cases, I am telling you. Now, Parkinson's has become such a easy, even some of my neurologists and neurosurgeons are astonished. What is that you people are doing it? I said that this miracle is happening because of the quantum energy. I am not doing anything. Okay, and further things I will tell you as I go ahead. Anything else, sir, here? Okay. Now, we know that it is offering breakthrough options in the treatment of many clinical conditions, but because of the time constraint, let me restrict today to only the chronic degenerative painful conditions. Okay. Now, let us see here. This is from the US statistics, US health statistics. The chronic pain, the number of people suffering as Americans are about 100 millions. This is from the Indian Institute of Medicine of the National Academics. Diabetes, 25.8 millions. Coronary heart disease, it's about 16.3 millions. Cancer, about 11.5 millions. When you add diabetes, coronary heart disease, cancer and everything, it comes hardly to somewhere around about 52 millions. Whereas the chronic pain sufferers is about 100 millions. The same thing is true in India also. There are major researches are going on. There are major hospitals, diagnostic centers for diabetes, coronary heart disease and cancer. How many are there for pain, my dear friends? How many specialists are there? How many? It is taken for granted. It is just taken for granted. Okay? Forget about all these big chronic degenerative condition. Let us further simplify. Just chronic neck pain, chronic low back pain, chronic knee pain. You go to any street in any city or any part of the country or the world, you say just neck pain, back pain, knee pain, about 10 people will come out. This has become very, very common. All these years it used to be from the aged people. Nowadays even the middle-aged people also are coming. Even the computer people, the IT engineers are coming. Even 29-year-old ladies are coming out with that. Because of the so many other conditions that I will explain you. And one more important thing that you have to remember, these ailments, the neck pain, back pain, knee pain, they look very, very common ailments. Remember, they are very, very costly ailments. They take away the quality of your life and even professions also many times. Oh. Hey. When you saw that 100 million people suffering from the chronic pain, even from the US statistics, 95% of these cases can be handled non-surgically. India is not different. But majority of the people, when they want non-surgical solutions, the available non-surgical solutions, for example, in my 41 years of career, the same analgesics, the molecules are changing, the oral steroids, viscose supplements, epidural injections, neck collars, lumbosacral belts, knee braces, repeated physiotherapies, and different systems of medicine, Ayurveda, homeopathy, naturopathy, endless. And they are not successful. Patients are desperate, hospitals are many, doctors are many, patients also too many. This is the real situation as of today in the country and in the world also. It is a very serious thing that we have to consider, not just running behind diabetes, heart conditions and cancer. These are the simplest things but most suffering thing. Surgery is recommended in most of the cases. How many people can afford in India? Majority of the people do not have insurance. To undergo a small surgery, they ask 10 relatives and they ask 10 patients who have undergone. Only then they will go up. When such be the condition and such be the mentality of the society, what is the viable option? We say that incorporate quantum energy medicine in that. But why? Why, if somebody says that quantum energy is, why do you fall for that? You must know the real truth, real logic behind that, how it works and in what way it is working. See, we have to understand the real drawbacks of the modern medical science. You know that we have put heavy emphasis on the prescription medications and completely disregarding the body's own innate ability to heal. This part, you know, we have to read and again. We cannot just ignore the innate ability, the body's own system. It is rare to see doctors talking about the mitochondrial dysfunction and energy dysregulation in the body. I am doing extensive work with doctors in National Institute of Health regarding this metabolic dysfunction. Okay, maybe we are still evaluating, treating based on the system, masking the symptoms only. When someone comes to me with a back pain, just prescribe him something, some local application, some oral application. Don't do that, don't sit, don't run, don't walk, don't do anything. Other than that, we are not doing anything at all here. We are just taking things for granted. And in the last 40 years, that is my 40 years of my medical practice, there is a limited therapeutic contribution to patient care in these lines. There used to be phenylbutazone, then oxyfenbutazone, now something else have come. Same molecules with no changes in the side effects. Same thing, patients continue, change the brand name, they take it and go away. Or they change the doctor, they change the hospital. So these are the drawbacks of our modern medical system. And then what we are missing actually, See, all these years, you know, medical science focused mainly on the biochemical processes and to some extent electromagnetic processes only for diagnostic, curative and research purpose. Anybody coming, they send him to the laboratory, do the blood investigations, how he gets all these reports, or send him to something for the recording, MRI or ECGs and all those things. We are just depending on those things, or just the ritual activities they have become. But actually, we never looked at the quantum processes of the body, which are vital and real code of all cellular processes. This, the medical science is not taught to the students in the medical colleges. Okay. And the therapeutic lasers has cracked this code and helped us to look beyond symptoms and to the real cause of the disease. This has uncovered the missing link in patients' disease conditions. So this particular slide is very, very important to understand the quantum energy medicine and its effect on the present day patient's life. Quantum energy medicine begins when no options are left with modern medicine. When I made this statement in one of the conferences, all my doctors objected to me about 6 years back. Now they are all concurring with me. Yes, you are correct. It is nice to hear. You also can hear it. But what and how do you do that? That's more important. How you are implementing this? What it is that you are doing it? That we have to see it. How we do that? See, as I told you that the regenerative model works on some of the systems that I said, the stem cell therapy and immune modulation. Other than that, there are some simplest things that we can implement even in any village or even in any clinic. You don't need a star hospital or anything. One is that the preventive care. You have to look at the patients, and when someone comes with a problem, what are the things that you can guide him to prevent to suffer that? And then metabolic programs. You have to correct the metabolic conditions. If the patient is suffering from diabetes or if even from the thyroid dysfunction or anything, the cells do not work normally. What is the normal work? They don't breathe normally, they don't eat properly, they don't produce proteins or hormones, and they don't reproduce. So you have to correct it. That is the fundamental thing that does not require any rocket science or have 10 postgraduate degrees to understand this. And then the targeted nutrition is more important. What kind of nutrition the patient is suffering from, that we have to see it and fill it up. And then the therapeutic lasers, the application, and the middle one. This middle one is my innovation that I have seen it from the last 6 years. That is the pyramid that I have mentioned. It is about the meditation or pranayama or whatever it is and all. What is the specialty of this pyramid is that people who cannot be induced easily into the meditation can be induced. People who are already into meditation, they can go to higher levels. I have taken many, even from Mumbai, some of the deputy general managers from, some cement company. He was not sleeping properly for years together. I took him. I slept along with him in the same pyramid valley. Saturday, Sundays, courtesy of Shreyans Dawaji from Mumbai. And that gentleman is so happy now, he doesn't do anything. Weekly once he goes and sleeps there and comes back. No medications, nothing. So like that, there are so many conditions, not one. Even migraine cases, even so many neuropsychiatric cases, they are all working. So that is why with the bold thing that I have mentioned, the pyramid there. Because it is my observation that I have seen it. If I go to Pyramid Valley, to particularly some chamber, King's Chamber or something, within 10 minutes I become finished. Somebody has to wake me up. I don't know what it is. I have never tried to study. I just accepted it and implemented it. It is benefiting my patients. And this is the what we call the components of the regenerative medicine and a pyramid meditation that I have mentioned what it is about. It is a multi-approach intervention for brain dysfunction, so whatever it is and all. Now this quantum energy therapeutic lasers, this is the way that we apply the therapeutic lasers to the different organs. That not just, you know, there are so many methods involved in it. Just pictorially I have shown that. And it is totally non-invasive. And I mentioned it as zero on all the six. In the last 8 years, nearly 7,000 cases of mainly the cervical, that is a chronic neck, back and knee pain and so many other neurological conditions I have treated. Remember, without using a single analgesic tablet, my pharmacist nearby is worried what kind of doctor he was thinking. Jensen, they were telling me that you are hitting our stomach. You are not prescribing anything at all to us, so many patients. Yes, God bless you, I told them. Okay? Now, we spoke so many things. Let us come to the specific thing here. Knee pain. Sir, another 7 minutes, I will close it. Nothing to worry about it. Okay?
5 minutes.
5 minutes, okay. I will just go very fast. See, this is the osteoarthritis, the knee, that is the knee pain. What is the condition, the knee pain that we see here? See, there is erosion of the cartilage ends and there is lack of synovial fluid. And the tensile capacity of the internal ligaments is gone and there is a lack of calcium in the bones and there is a muscle spasm. This is the condition that we get. But for these things, you know, what is the corrective remedy that we do? We give them the nutrition, perfect nutrition of the proteins and everything, and then calcium thing, and then we administer therapeutic lasers. What therapeutic lasers does? It improves the cellular level functions. It enhances the cellular permeability. Lot of nutrition that we are giving, it is gushing in. It stimulates the mitochondria, produces lot of energy. It improves the all complete cellular functions. Within no time, the patient's that synovial fluid secretion starts. Muscle spasm will come down. Patients say, I am feeling better. This is not possible by any other means in our modern medical science. That is where the quantum energy medicine, it is making it possible. Patients feel better. Most of the patients who come to us, they don't want to run, they are not athletes, they are all old people. They want to do household chores, that's all. They want to go to temple and sit down, they want to walk and come back. That's all. We are easily achieving this. Now, okay, this is one. This is what I explained to you. And now again, the chronic neck pain and back pain. So this is the picture, normal picture, the how the nerves are emanating from the vertebral column. And this is the graphical picture of what happens in case of neck pain, the disc generated pain, that is discogenic origin. There is a disc bulge, people usually call it as. Whenever there is a disc bulge, that the picture in the bigger one, you can see that the nucleus bulbosus that is in the center, which is acidic in nature, that gushes into the nerves where it is as the alkaline in nature, it causes irritation. And even the surrounding thing, that annulus fibrosis is very fragile in nature, the fragments of that go and sit in the neural foramina. So where even the surgeon's knife cannot reach there. So what the surgical lasers can't do, that what is that our quantum energy medicine works here. Quantum energy medicine, it works by increasing the phagocytic activity. The phagocytes become superactive, they start eating this fragment that is a dead tissue and they reduce the size of that. They reduce the inflammation, they reduce the acidic level of that and they reduce the inflammatory enzymes also. Patient on the 4th and 5th day, he says, I am feeling better, there is not much of radiculopathy. And the further treatment starts, commences with the nutrition and physiotherapy, other things. So that is what we are doing in case of cervical spondylosis and lumbar spondylosis, provided if it is due to the discogenic origin, not because of the disc generated osteophytes and all. They all require surgical corrections. We treat the first four conditions. The first four conditions we treat better with therapeutic lasers, that is quantum energy medicine. And I am not just talking like that only. These are the number of cases that I have treated from 2011 onwards up to 2017. And all these things I have presented in many international conferences also. And you look at the percentage of success normally in any medical profession, even before that 2010, I used to get around 35% to 40% success rate maximum. Now we have reached up to 79% to 80%. Three slides, sir. What is the future of therapeutic lasers? You say that laser is unimaginable. There are more than 200 million people in the country suffering from this chronic degenerative condition. There is a great need of trained doctors and thousands of centers all over the country. ReMeD has made all necessary preparation to launch its franchisee operations. Next. And even I conducted an international conference myself in 2016, inviting all the eminent doctors all over the world. We can do anything for anybody because the doctors need here the knowledge about these things. How to make the knowledge to reach the thousands and thousands of doctors all over the country and the neighboring countries. For that, we have made an IMED varsity. This is empowering practicing doctors practically at their place and pace. We have made all the necessary arrangements. Even the abroad universities are offering them degree also. And they can study online. Okay. Thank you very much. This is what about me. Thank you.